we're gonna tell you, like, because you know it's a lot of different denominations.
Yeah, I know.
A lot of different, like people say we Christian and you know Christianity and stuff like that.
Protestant.
Yeah, because look at this sign right here. All that religion.
Man-made religion.
You can't find me nowhere in the Bible where God tell you to be a Christian, Jehovah Witness, a Pentecostal, Baptist. He ain't never tell my people to be that. What did he tell our people to be? You look at this sign over here, we did 12 signs each. So-called black, Puerto Ricans, Spanish, they all this.
I see what you mean.
Yeah,
Buddha is American blood.
Yeah.
Benjamin is Swiss Indian blood.
Right.
Divide Haitian. That guy Haitian.
Right.
Speaking right now.
Right. So this is what we out here teaching our people. Watch this. Give me Jeremiah 17 and verse 4. Because back in all these captivities that we had, our people, we really lost our history and our identity, who we really are in the Bible. Because you can't find in the Bible where a person can say, I'm Puerto Rican, I'm Jamaican, I'm Haitian, it ain't in there. So it's biblical names. All right, watch this, read that.
Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 4. Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 4. And thou even thyself,
this is Jeremiah saying, him, even himself, go ahead,
shall discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thy enemies in the land which thou knowest not. For ye have kindled a fire in my anger.
Right, so Jeremiah said that we would lose our identity, we would lose our heritage. So when we lost our identity and lost our heritage, people from Puerto Rico, they call themselves Puerto Rican. What do Puerto Rican mean?
I don't really know.
That means that rich is a port. Rich port. That's when Columbus, when he came to the island of Puerto Rico, that's what he called that island. He called it the port of riches. So he called it the port of riches. So that's why when y'all call yourself Puerto Rican, y'all call it what the name that Christopher Columbus that conquered that land was called.
They
y'all.
Passed the port,
right? And if you look at this sign right here.
But there's a lot of country.
Right here.
A lot of country missing there.
Right. I'm going to show you. See these right here? This was found by a scientist in Puerto Rico. He found these Hebrew stones. 800 Hebrew stones in Puerto Rico.
Have you heard of that?
How did he find 8 Hebrew stones in Puerto Rico? What is these Hebrew stones doing in Puerto Rico? Because the people from Puerto Rico are the true Hebrews. That's why. Before they started getting conquered by Christopher Columbus and Christianity, these people knew they were Hebrews. What's that saying? Boricua.
Boricua.
What that mean?
Boricua?
Yeah, that's a Hebrew word. A lot of Puerto Ricans say that word and they don't know they actually speak in the Hebrew tongue.
Yeah, but you have to have like something. Because I know you're explaining that, but you have to have.
Oh, I'm going to show you on the bike.
No, because I don't have much time to go through all the study.
Right.
But,
yeah,
that's good. If you use the Bible, that's good.
Yeah, we do in-depth research.
What do you think about Jesus?
A lot of people represent.
He's our Lord. He died for us, for the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
A lot of people misrepresent Jesus this very day. You know, they put this image up and say, this is Jesus. Jesus looked more like this guy. Because he come from a region right here of Africa. Right here, Jerusalem is East Africa.
The people over there know as the resurrection, not even the apostles recognize him because he had a glorified body.
Right, right. He had a glorified body. So like we're saying, Jesus looked more like this guy. But when Jesus was on the scene, when he was teaching people, the Bible says Jesus was an all-spirit man. That's right, when they were doing the taxes, what did he go in there and do? He took the table, knocked him down. Jesus wasn't playing games. I'm going to give you one scripture and tell me how you ever heard this. Go to Luke 19 and I think verse 27. Let's see what Jesus Christ did.
They have sent you.
47. Yeah. Yeah, right here. Watch this. This is Jesus Christ. Look at that in red. That's red letter, right?
That's good. Yeah.
Let's see what Jesus Christ said out of his own mouth. Go ahead.
Luke chapter 19 and verse 27. But those my enemies.
So Jesus Christ said he got enemies. But people say Jesus loves everybody in the world. He loves all mankind. Why is he saying he got enemies?
I think there's something that you have to know the context.
No, we know the context of because people represent misrepresent
Christ. If you love the Lord, you'll become enemy of God.
Right. Let's read what he said about it. Okay.
But those my enemies, which would not that I should rule over them.
And them that I should not rule over them, what are you going to say?
Bring hither.
Bring them to me. What are you going to say? We're going to say, he said, bring them to me and let me teach them or let me give them a kiss and a hug. Bring them to me and do what?
And slay them.
And kill them
before me.
That's right. You know Jesus Christ said that?
Yeah, well, I know I read the Old Testament.
Right.
But I'm not agreeing with you, so let me leave you alone. You see how they
Right.
People really,
right. A lot of people, they say they believe in the Bible till we actually read it.
What the hell? Wait a minute.
He said he don't believe in my teaching. That ain't my teaching. That's what the Bible says. The Bible said that. I didn't say a word.
He said, no, este no es escrito.
I don't believe in your teaching. I didn't say nothing. Read it again for the camera.
Read it again.
Luke chapter 19 and verse 27. But those my enemies, which would not that I should rule over them, bring hither and slay them before me.
Oh, praise.
Right. Man, you Christians, y'all don't really believe in the Bible.
That's right.
Y'all say y'all believe in the Bible. Y'all love Christ. Y'all love that white man Jesus.
Bring it out, dog.
Y'all love that feminine guy, that little social sissy dude, the one running around. Y'all don't love the austere Jesus, the one that's an austere man.
That's right.
Right. Give me that scripture for Jesus is an austere man.
Luke chapter 19 and verse 20. And another came saying, Lord, behold, here is thou proud, which I have kept laid up in a napkin.
Right, so this is the guy that with the pound. This guy didn't produce nothing with his pound. He didn't produce nothing. He didn't go out and do the work. He didn't do nothing. He kept it in a napkin, right? So let's see what this guy that kept his pound in a napkin, what he said about Christ.
For I feared you, because thou art an austere man.
There are an austere man. Christ was an austere man. Christ wasn't that little feminized guy that everybody out here teaching in the Bible.
That's right.
Right? People listen to Christ like he was a soft man. It's like y'all be hearing the background. This guy right here preaching another. Give me that in Matthew. Chapter 24.
Blood of a slave, heart of a king. Blood of a slave, heart of a king. Blood of a slave, heart of a king. Brave heart.
Hi, shalom from Israel. This is Ola, the daughter of Jethro. And I just heard that you black people that was stolen from Africa to America, that you don't know who you are, but you are the children of Yahweh, the children of Israel. And I'm telling you, you have to come back to your homeland, here to Zion, to Jerusalem, because us the Gentiles, we do need you. We need you to come and pray because you are our saviors. You the one that was chosen by Yahweh to live in this land, not the Jewish people, it's you. You were stolen from Africa, they deceived you, they told you that you are slaves, but you actually the children of Israel. And it's time just to come back. Come for your people, come back for us, come back for the whole Gentiles, because only you gonna save us. So please come back to Zion.